So we've previously talked about how a case gets to the Supreme Court. Now this video is going to focus on, okay, you're the rare case, you reach the Supreme Court decides to hear your case, like how does the argument stuff go down, right? And I think what people find is that it's very different from the types of like legal cases they're used to seeing on TV. Like you watch a movie or a TV show and you see like all of like the way court cases are conducted. That's not really how it goes down in the Supreme Court. So first thing to note is that Supreme Court cases are always a petitioner versus a respondent. So the petitioner is always sort of mentioned at the beginning of the Supreme Court case, and then the respondent comes after, right? So it's like Roe v. Wade, right? Famous abortion case. Whoever comes first, you know that they lost in whatever court most recently heard their decision, and they want the Supreme Court to overturn the verdict. The respondent, right, in Roe v. Wade, the famous abortion case, whoever comes on the right side of the V, right, Wade, won in the lower court. They're called the respondent, and they want the Supreme Court to sort of like uphold the lower court's like ruling. So that kind of shows you who's fighting against who and like what their differences are. Most of the argumentation that's done occurs way before you actually appear in court. Each side will write what's called a brief, and they're really misnamed because they're not short, they're really long, but it's like a summary of your argument, like why you are right and why the Supreme Court should rule in your favor and why the other side is wrong. And there are these massive arguments. This is one of the reasons why the Supreme Court can only take like a couple cases in a year because it's so much reading. And the clerks might help them read through like these briefs as well. We talked about the clerks in the previous like discussion. And these written arguments are going to focus on like precedent. Like, hey, you already ruled like this in the past in a case kind of related, so you have to rule the same way for us. Or if you rule this way, this is the dangerous example you're going to be establishing for the future, right? And it's a lot of reading. Each side in the case will submit this massive sort of written argument that each of the nine judges will have to read before the actual case arrives in the Supreme Court. It's also possible for additional groups to file briefs. These are called amicus curiae briefs, which is like Latin for like friend of the court. It's an outside group that's not directly involved in the suit, but like they feel like their organization might be impacted by whatever decision the Supreme Court might make. And they want to like weigh in as well. And this might be another like 20 to 30 briefs that the Supreme Court justices will have to like read through. So again, like most of the action is taking place in like written form, right? It's not until the very end that each of the groups like involved in the case like has their day in court. And these are called oral arguments. And this like works a lot differently than like the favorite court like show or movie you like might have watched in the past, where like there's cross examinations and witnesses and I object and sustained and like evidence and all that kind of stuff. Like you're simply giving an oral argument, like your side's lawyers, right, on like to the judges, right, to the nine Supreme Court judges. And like they don't get a whole lot of time. Like you get 30 minutes to basically make your argument in front of the judges, each side. So like in the famous abortion case of Roe v. Wade, the Roe lawyers got 30 minutes. And like the Wade lawyers got 30 minutes. There's no witnesses. And at any point, you can be interrupted by the justices for like questioning, which makes it hard to argue in front of the Supreme Court. Now, like all these things you want to say, but at any point they can cut you off. They can ask you about something you said. They can ask you about something that you wrote in your brief. It's sort of like a question and answer kind of thing. So it works very differently from your traditional court case. If you think about like all the really significant issues that are being argued in front of the Supreme Court, each side only gets 30 minutes maximum. And again, most of the argumentation is done in written form before you even get your day in court. So this is how the Supreme Court cases are actually argued in front of the justices.